B-2 Spirit bomber revolutionized strategic aviation with its stealth capabilities. Russia, trailing the U.S. in stealth technology, is developing the Tupolev. PAK-DA as its answer to the B-2. Nearing prototype completion, the PAK-DA aims to match U.S. capabilities with plans for additional bombers. However, Russia's progress lags due to its historical delays in weapons development and current resource strain from the Ukraine conflict. Since the dissolution of the Soviet Union, Russia has spent considerable sums to maintain and eventually modernize a trio of Cold War strategic bomber types, all built by the Tupolev company. The 1950s-era Tu-95 Bear bomber with contra-rotating propellers today has a standoff attack operating concept, much like the U.S. Air Force's B-52 bombers. The supersonic Tu-22M Backfire is a medium-range jet bomber. Russia also possesses 17 humongous Tu-100 and 60 Blackjack with intercontinental flight ranges, huge payload capacity, and a modestly reduced radar cross-section. The Ministry of Defense has also poured money into cruise and hypersonic missiles, which allow these non-stealthy bombers to attack targets from well beyond the range of air defenses. Concept work on the PAK-DA began all the way back in the late 1990s, but research and development was only formally kicked off in 2007. Despite difficulties financing Russian defense programs, particularly the Su-57 stealth fighter, the PAK-DA has progressively overcome development and bureaucratic hurdles. While designed in the stealth-friendly flying wing style, it's uncertain if the PAK-DA will achieve its 2027 mass production goal, especially as Russia prioritizes immediate wartime needs over advanced technology projects. The B-2 Spirit bomber was a strategic game-changer. It was introduced as the first aircraft that could avoid radar detection and deliver nuclear ordnance. In the decades since the B-2 debuted, the Russians have yearned to mitigate a clear American advantage by launching a peer aircraft of their own. Tupolev is reportedly nearing completion of a PAK-DA prototype, with plans for 6 more bombers in place. If these plans come to reality, Russia would join the Americans as the only nations on Earth with stealth bombers. China is currently rushing to develop their Chinon H-20 stealth bomber. Russia has an accomplished history of aerospace design, but with respect to stealth technology, Moscow lags far behind its chief rival. The United States has led on stealth technology ever since it unveiled the F-117 Nighthawk and B-2 Spirit 3 decades ago. Now the U.S. flies a fleet of fifth-generation fighters, the F-22 and F-35, that feature stealth technology. The B-21 Raider, a replacement for the now-outdated B-2 Spirit, has begun test flights and is expected to join the U.S. Air Force within the next few years. The Americans have about a generation's worth of a head start on the Russians with respect to producing stealth bombers. Both Russia and China are rushing to catch the Americans. China's H-20 remains in the prototype phase, and Beijing probably has a long way to go before releasing something akin to the B-2 or B-21. Russia is reportedly closer than the Chinese with the PAK-DA, but the program is shrouded in secrecy. Little is known about the bomber. If Western intelligence agencies have an informed understanding of the PAK-DA and of where the program is at, they haven't disseminated that information to the general public. The PAK-DA will likely fly at subsonic speeds, like the B-2. The PAK-DA is expected to have a low radar cross-section, meaning the jet will rely on stealth, not speed, to avoid detection. This is easier said than done, and the Russians do not have a great track record of releasing impressive stealth aircraft. The Russians' only stealth fighter, the Su-57, is understood to have the worst stealth performance of all the stealth fighters. But who knows, maybe the Russians have quietly improved their stealth capabilities. The flying wing design, streamlined and sleek, is inherently stealth-friendly. The Russians hope the PAK-DA enters mass production by 2027. Knowing the Russians' history of slow weapons program rollouts, the timeline feels overly optimistic. The war in Ukraine no doubt consumes resources and industrial capabilities that might otherwise be used to develop a new stealth aircraft. But right now, Russian priorities run toward simply keeping their war effort afloat, rather than developing the technology of the future. Russia will probably have to focus not on ambitious stealth bomber projects, but on more practical aims, such as resupplying armored personnel carriers and tanks to frontline forces who are entering year 3 of an attritional war. With the Russian military now bogged down in the conflict in Ukraine, and with sanctions affecting the production capacity of the country's industry, especially with regard to high-technology aerospace components, the timing of the patent may be slightly surprising. Thanks to a patent filed for an engine intake duct design, we may have gotten our first look at least the basic design concept behind Russia's long-in-development Tupolev PAK-DA bomber. Work on the long-range subsonic bomber ultimately planned to succeed the Tupolev 295MS Bear H and 2160 Blackjack has been ongoing since at least 2007. But so far, there have been no confirmed official models or artworks indicating how it might actually look, although it has been widely reported as a flying wing design. The flying wing design illustrated very loosely similar to the U.S. Air Force's B-2 Spirit, with the same sharp beak, forward-set cockpit, and with engine intakes on the upper surfaces of the wing/body on either side. Where the Spirit is essentially a 35-degree angle flying wing/fuselage with a serrated trailing edge, this apparent PAK-DA design depicts an aircraft with a similarly angled nose, but with a pronounced cranked wing. As a result, the narrower outboard sections of the wings have a much less severe angle of sweep. Compared to the B-2, the trailing edge is also far simpler, having more in common with cranked kite layouts like the X-47B drone, and also with the Russian S-70 Okhotnik, although with reduced angles of sweep. Furthermore, the simplicity of the trailing edge at least is very loosely similar to official renderings of the U.S. Air Force's new B-21 Raider. Again, however, it should be noted that the few depictions of the B-21 released so far may well differ in some aspects from the final aircraft. In general terms, the patent drawing suggests an aircraft that is clearly not in the very low observable, VITA low class, but rather has some thought given to a degree of low observability, a low. Like the B-21, it could have a high operating ceiling, but in terms of stealth, it would seem to have the same kind of relationship to the B-2 as the Su-57 Felon does to the F-22 Raptor. Other, slightly less reliable sources have disclosed a planned takeoff weight of 145,000 kilograms, 160 tons, and a weapons load of 30,000 kilograms, 33 tons. Weapons are expected to include new generation standoff missiles carried on a pair of rotary launchers in internal weapons bays. The primary basic load is likely to comprise 12 new KBD long-range subsonic cruise missiles, which are intended to have a greater range than the current KIT-100 and 1/100 seconds. The conventionally armed Q-101, known to NATO as the S-23A Kodiak, has a reported maximum range of between around 1,870 and 2,480 miles, and the nuclear Q-102 is said to be able to fly further. One prominent feature of the patent drawing that might not be found in the definitive PAK-DA is the kinked wing. Russian aviation expert Pyotr Butowski, in a recent article for Aviation Week, claims that the final aircraft will likely have a constant leading edge angle, like that of the B-2, and likely also the B-21 Raider. Indeed, that change would lead to a configuration much more similar to the official renderings of the B-21. The decision to commit to the development of a stealth bomber sheds in a new light on a long history of scorn cast by Russian media on the effectiveness of stealth aircraft, posited to be highly vulnerable to new radars. Apparently, former Deputy Prime Minister Dmitry Rogozin truly did hold this point of view, and in 2012 criticized the PAK-DA program and stealth bombers more generally. Look at the level of development of anti-aircraft and anti-missile defenses. All these planes will never get near their targets. Not ours, not theirs. However, both Putin and then-President Medvedev subsequently affirmed their support for the PAK-DA, so it seems establishment broadly drew the opposite conclusion. Indeed, a project like the PAK-DA will demand a more rigorous and expensive stealth optimization than was necessary for Russia's Su-57 stealth fighter, which is both agile enough to avoid threats and is only intended to perform comparatively shallow penetration of hostile airspace, as reflected by a lack of rearward stealth. If you enjoy content like this, please go ahead and like and subscribe to this video because I appreciate all your support.